Okay, Michael, so you might ask me why we would do feature transformation. And I think the answer is obvious even to the most casual observer. We actually just went through a couple of examples in the previous slide, like XOR, the kernel methods, all of these things we've done before, where effectively we were doing feature transformation. In fact, you could argue that things like neural networks are already doing feature transformation. So we've been doing feature transformation all along. And so the real question here is there some specific reason why we should do this feature transformation explicitly and separate from some specific learning algorithm that is doing its own feature transformation, such as a perceptron or a neural network or support vector machines? So I'm just going to very quickly go through a simple example that I hope illustrates why you might want to do this, but it's still kind of a large, relevant example. Okay, you with me?
I'm ready.
Okay, so here's the problem I'm going to describe. And I'm not going to do it in a lot of detail. I really just want to give you an intuition. That problem is information retrieval. So in particular, I'm talking about what's called ad hoc retrieval. Do you know what the ad hoc retrieval problem is?
I assume that if you start with a key and you add hoc to it, you get hockey.
No, that would be a kind of feature transformation. We would call that the pun transformation. The ad hoc retrieval problem, maybe I can help you out by calling it by another nickname. It's the Google problem, which is you have a whole bunch of documents in some database somewhere. This is me drawing a database. And you want to retrieve exactly the subset of documents that are relevant to some query. So this is me drawing documents. So I might type in a word like machine learning into some text box somewhere, click on some button, and then get back a list of relevant documents nicely sorted against a white background. And this is the ad hoc query problem, the ad hoc retrieval problem. I give you some features, which in this case are words, and you return objects, in this case documents, that are somehow relevant to those features. Okay? So we do this all the time.
What makes it ad hoc as opposed to what?
There's various other kinds of information retrieval problems. This one's just called the ad hoc one. What's ad hoc about it is that you don't already know what the queries are. You aren't doing something like clustering the documents. It's just that you're going to be given some unknown query, which is in some feature space, and you're just going to have to retrieve the things that are relevant. So it's just always been called the ad hoc problem, as far as I know. I guess because you don't know what these are going to be beforehand.
Yeah, and like as opposed to maybe some kind of standing query. Like I want any information that talks about the OMS program, please alert me.
Right, exactly. And that's actually got a name too. It's not the standing query problem, but it's a kind of triage problem. I can't remember what it's called right now. But yeah, so there's different versions of this. This one is in some ways the hardest because you can't do a lot of very clever things up front in order to figure out the best way to store your documents because you don't know what this ad hoc query is going to be. Okay? All right. So, why is this problem hard other than by saying, I don't know what this is going to be? So let's think about it in terms of the features that you have.